Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial series. My name is Nico and in this series I'm going to walk you through the steps necessary to create a nice diamond ring. Now this is going to be a studded ring that has diamonds going all the way around it, but hopefully the steps that you see in this tutorial will help you create your own designs as well. So if you're interested in doing jewelry, pay attention and let's jump into it. To get started, I'm going to go into the side panel and over to the settings. And then I'm going to go into the grid units and I want to set this into millimeters. This is going to help us essentially keep everything at a good and realistic scale. So now that I have that millimeters, I'm good to go. I'm going to zoom in here and I'm just going to start off by drawing a circle. Now I'm in the front view and I'm going to draw a circle and you'll see that that circle forms and we have a surface. I don't need the surface right now. So I'm going to double tap on it and erase it. I want to select this curve here. I'm going to bring it over, snap it to the grid. So now that is snapped to the grid. And I want to see the size of it. Right now it is 6.56 millimeters. The size 6, which is kind of a relatively standard size of a ring, is about 16.4 millimeters. I looked that up earlier today. I didn't know. So I'm going to make this 16.4 millimeters. And I tapped on this lock icon here, and that'll keep the proportions the same. It means that both sides will be rescaled to 16.4. So there we go. That's 16.4 millimeters. That's a good size for us to start with. This ring that, or this circle that we drew, is essentially going to be used as a guide circle for what we do next. So the next thing I want to do is I want to actually go into the playground over here. And I'm going to go down to product, jewelry, and you'll see that it opens, when you go to jewelry, it opens by default in the gemstone pack. And we have tons of various gemstones, heart-shaped or heart-cut gemstones, old single gemstones, emeralds, trillions, pear-cut, circle-cut, table-cut, oval, and so we have a nice set of various gemstones. I'm going to take the circle-cut. I've always liked circle-cuts, and I think for this ring, it'll look better. I'm just going to tap it and then bring it in and I'm going to drop it right about here for now. Now that looks relatively big for the size of the ring. I want to make this a little bit smaller. So I'm going to just scale it, select the whole thing, scale it down. You can turn snap to grid off for now. I don't really need that. And I'm going to bring this basically down to so that the tip is on the ring and I want to just snap it or kind of center it over this axis. So just move it where you need it and kind of reevaluate, keep reevaluating the size. I think I'm going to go something like this. I'll bring this down a little bit more. There we go. So hopefully that's not too small, but I think for a ring that should be good. All right. Now the next step that we want to do is we are going to go to the side view. And we are just basically going to draw a profile for the ring. So I'm just going to move this quickly and center it there. And we're going to draw a curve that's going to essentially make the profile of a ring. And we're going to create a revolved surface out of that. So I'm only going to draw half of it, and then I'm going to mirror it over. So I'm just going to draw a shape like that. Well, that didn't work out at all. Sorry about that. Let's try that again. Nice curve, over, down, and something like that. Let's try it one more time. Now you can always edit these curves. I'm trying to get something pretty nice straight off the bat. That's okay. So I'm going to come in and just edit this quickly. Now we want the stone to stick up a little bit, so I'm going to just move some of these points down. Nice thing is that we have these joined points here, so that'll give us a nice kind of edge here. Dragging these points down. And if we don't need ones, for example, like this one, I don't think I need this one. I'm just going to tap and delete it. Keep in mind, always, the simpler the less points you have and the simpler the curve, the better your design can look. Now I'm going to actually start coming in and deleting some more points here. I just don't need those. Make this bottom section just a little bring this over here, make this a little bit thicker. Now this is a part that's going to go against your finger. I don't need these. That looks like a nice little profile there. Bring this over. There we go. And so these are actually, I'm gonna pull this these control points down a little bit more. And there is our profile. I'm gonna stop here for now, and then we're gonna go through and kind of clean this up a little bit more in the second tutorial, add some posts around the gemstone, and create the actual ring. So I hope you enjoy this. I hope this is a good start. I know we didn't do a whole lot. We just basically drew a circle, brought in a gemstone, and started modifying a curve that we drew. But in the next step, you're going to see that all of this will come together very nicely. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, definitely let us know. And stay tuned for the next lesson. Take care, guys.